not really sure where I've left you because I worked a lot in the background in the last few weeks now. I bought another house. I wanted for a while to buy a shop. I searched for months and months and I couldn't make a deal. So I've bought something else because I want to invest some money this year. And I bought another house, and because of that, I was between these two houses. I worked in here some stuff. I have to renovate in there. I have to find somebody to live in there. And anyway, I worked a lot in the garage to a lot of cars that I didn't want to film that. Because I wasn't worth to film. It was just flip cars, one after another and stuff like that. But now we are back. Now we are going to fix another problem on the F32, yeah. Because when I bought the car, I had three problems with the car. One key, and we solved that. In this episode, we are going to fix the second problem. That's the rain sensor. The auto mode, it doesn't work because the rain sensor has a gel pad in there on the windscreen, and it's like matte, and we have to fix that in this episode. And I've bought a new garage car, shop car, and we are going to drive the new car home, and we are going to have a look at that shop car. Oh, and I bought another project car, but all of that in the next few episodes. So let's start the video. It's time to fix the rain sensor in there. Check this out. Maybe you can see in there how this gel is like matte. Check this out, we have a lot of freaking silicone. The old sensor was glued in there with silicone. Holy smokes. And now we have to take all the silicone out. See that? And new gel, we have the new gel in there, and we can fix this. Sensor is out, we've cleaned everything in there as much as we could. All the debris are in here, and now we just have to install the new pad, gel pad, and job done. Haha, it's working! Check this out! Woohoo! Finally! Nice. I've paid the man, I put everything back together, everything is done and it's working. I still have a small problem in there. I'm gonna show you, but I have to be somewhere now. I'm gonna show you what's the problem that it's remained. It's nothing tragic or something like that. The sensor had a clip that is hold the sensor pressed to the glass, and that the clip is not that good anymore, but I don't have any part now, and I have to order that a new one, and that's about it. But it's working. And now test on the road. You can clearly see in there that the wipers auto mode is activated. We have some small rain, and normally it should start from itself. I'm quite curious, to be honest. I have to approach the other car that is going to throw some water on my windshield. Yes! Finally it's working! Finally, after almost 1 year of not having this auto mode, now it's working. Perfect! And I'm driving the new car for the shop. For the noise, it's from the number plate, it's shaking. Between the glass. Anyway, we have a Peugeot Partner, a minivan that we are driving home now. It is the cheapest one on German marketplace, and it's bad, really bad. I keep straightening the steering wheel because it wants to drive left. Anyway, I'm not sure if the turn signals are working. We are going to drive the car home and we are going to see what we bought. Still alive. This car is a piece of crap. Oh my god. The steering wheel, I have to keep it straight, otherwise I'm going to fly off the street. check this out. Oh my god, it's sketchy. We had for a few seconds a stoplight with red on the dash. The turn signal on the right side is not working somewhere in the front or in the back. I'm not really sure if the brake lights are working. But we just have like 6 kilometers, something like that, and we are home. But we have climate control, automatic windows. The car is very clean on the inside here in the cabin. In the back I didn't check because it was so cheap and I just bought it. And we are home with the car, and this is the new shop car. Just a second to show you the whole thing. See that we can carry a lot of stuff with this. It has a lot of dents and nicks, and it beeps randomly. I'm not really sure why. We have to check that for sure. I didn't open the bonnet for now. I didn't even check if this door opens. Oh, nice. This one is working, this one as well. But in there, the whole plastic thing is... oh my god, I have to take that out completely, that part out. We have another door in here, but it's completely destroyed. Not completely. Let's see if this one works. Oh, it's working. Let's see. Yeah, it locks. Perfect. This is what I need. I can take this plastic thing out because it's completely destroyed. This one works as well. Oh, we have some stuff in the car. Okay. In here, nothing. Nothing. We have a radio. I saw that. And other than that, no idea. This fender is a different color and it was painted. It has a small accident in here, as I can see. But it doesn't bother me at all because, like I said, I want to carry stuff with this car. Let me use my both hands in order to open the bonnet to see what we have in here. Engine bay compartment. Not really sure. I think this is factory. This thing is the factory because there is the plug for the engine computer. But we have some oil leakage from the cover, engine cover. We have some oil leakage, I think, everywhere. So I have to check the belts. Oh, we have some oil leakage in here as well. Okay, I just have to check everything in order to drive the car on the street because I don't want to have some problems. We have climate control for sure. It's not working. I didn't even test that. Oh, check this out. What the heck is here wrong? Holy smokes, what's that? Okay, some crazy stuff in here. Okay, we have to check that. That's why I had a strange feeling on the clutch pedal. But I have to take everything from here out to see what's wrong and what's underneath. We have to do an oil change, filter change, and the other stuff. We have some crazy zip ties everywhere. But the car drives and runs normal. See that? This one was blue and they painted just here. Anyway, this is not a problem. I just have to check the engine mounts because I was having some crazy shakes from the engine side or something on the wheels. But it's here. We are going to put it on the inspection pit to check everything. And by the way, I just bought a car with, of course, one key. Let's start the car to see if we still have that stoplight. No, not anymore. I just have to figure out how to set the time, and we can check the car underneath. I've already started working on the car, but it's a mess in here. And I'm going to explain you quickly why. I just wanted to replace this gasket and this gasket. In order to do that, you have to remove the EGR pipe, and that's when the problem started. I removed the half part from the intake, which is the black thing in there. And we have another part, a metal part from the intake in here, and the exhaust manifold. And on the exhaust manifold we have the EGR pipe. This is the exhaust manifold, and the EGR pipe was bolted in here. And of course I had like a million problems removing the, those two screws in order to take the pipe out. And this is the pipe. I had to break the pipe in order to take out the exhaust manifold, which is this one. And this one has a broken stud in there. This is the normal screw that you have to put in there. And in here I have some luckily I have some screw in there. I put a nut, and now I'm going to weld that nut in there and take this piece out. So all that work just to replace the cover, because the EGR pipe was here above, and I had to take this plastic cover from the timing belt because it was bolted in here on the cover as well. So I worked like a lot for nothing. And when I want to replace this gasket, the gasket is right in there. The gasket doesn't fit because this cover, it was flat, and you have to, it's with silicone from the factory. And I received a gasket for the facelift model, I think, because this gasket has some grooves. You have to push it inside into the cover, but like I said, that was flat. And now I'm waiting for this gasket, for this part, and of course the other gasket, exhaust gasket, manifold gasket, intake gasket, like everything I've ordered new. And now let's the welder is already here, and I've already tried to weld a few nuts, as you can see in there, one, like three, four, I'm not sure where are the other ones, three, four tries, and it doesn't weld. I'm not sure, I'm pretty sure this one is a crap welder. So I'm going to go to a welding shop to weld that for good and take the bolt out. Oh, and I took this door apart because the window wasn't working, and of course the window regulator was bad. We have the glass in here, we have the regulator with the motor in there. I've already ordered a new regulator. I'm going to update you and start working when I have all the parts, and we are going to finish this one in one episode. Quick update on the Peugeot. I've went to a shop, they welded a nut in there, and they couldn't take the bolt out. It's like, maybe you can see, it will focus. Near the bolt we have some stuff in there, glue or something like that. Anyway, we have to drill this out because we cannot take this out. So that's that. Everything is clean, the intake, the EGR, everything. I've managed to take the EGR from here out. I've cut the bolts, but we can put new bolts in there. I just have to order a new EGR pipe because I had to break that. And I received some parts, I think all the parts in fact. This is the fender line liner in here, because we have a lot of dirt and we have some cables, see that, and I don't want to the water to go in there or to mess up some wires. We have the gasket for the cover, we have some belts, the gaskets for the exhaust, for the intake, for the exhaust itself, for the exhaust manifold, exhaust thermostat, oil filter, diesel filter, and air filter. And I think we have everything, but we are going to do all the work in the next episode, because now I have to wait for the EGR pipe. I have to try to take that bolt out, to drill, to tap, and after that we can put everything back together. So I think I'm going to close the video in here. And if you want to see more progress on this car, this will be the shop car. We are going to carry a lot of stuff with this one. I know it's in the rough shape, but I don't want to pay too much money for a car that I use just to carry stuff, and it's going to be full of oil in the back and stuff like that. Anyway, Like I said, if you want to see more progress on this car, join me on the next episode. If you like this episode, please give me a thumbs up. If you don't like the video, as usual, thumbs down. Until next time, see you later.